and welcome back to my channel. Or if it's your first time watching, welcome. Make sure you hit that subscribe button if you haven't done so already and turn on those notifications so you guys can be notified anytime I upload a new video. In today's video, we are going to be reviewing the new Wet n Wild 2019 collection. So in today's video, I am going to be going over all their new products, but the main focus of this video is the Photo Focus Stick Foundation, which just recently launched. This retails for $4.99 at your wetandwildbeauty.com and at your local CVS. This is a satin finish foundation. It is medium to full coverage. Because it's part of their Photo Focus line, it is meant for photos. It's meant for filming. It's meant for selfies. So this is going to give you a photo focus look. So with that being said, I am wearing it on my skin right now. So without wasting any more of your guys' precious time, let's go ahead and jump into the demo. Okay guys, so to start off this demo portion of this video, the first box is the Wet n Wild Primer and Foundation 2019 collection. Looks like this, beautiful packaging. It looks like a giant book. So inside we do get 4 foundations and 3 of the primer water. So I'm gonna show you guys on camera. So as you guys can see, I got 4 foundations, a little list of all the foundation shades, and then 3 primer waters. The primer waters come in rose, coconut, and cucumber, which I'm really excited because my favorite scent is coconut. Okay, so with the primer water, you guys, it comes in 3 heavenly scents, gives your skin the love and hydration it deserves. Infused with chamomile and cucumber extract, this lightweight primer soothes, refreshes, and hydrates skin instantly, leaving it softer and more radiant than ever. While green tea extract works to nourish your complexion with the rich antioxidant properties it's longing for. Pump just a few sprays to prep your skin, to set makeup, or to just refresh. This does retail for $4.99. and will be in mass retailers January 2019. So it's already in stores. So let's take that and spritz my face. So I'm just gonna shake it up and I'm gonna spritz my face. This smells so good. So with the foundation, I did receive 4 different tones. There is 21 available shades. They sent me the 4 shades that I guess are closer to my match. I feel like I'm actually buff beige, but they didn't send me that shade. So I'm gonna go ahead and either use classic beige or golden honey. So tested under 7 different photo lighting conditions on various skin tones with and without the flash, this breakthrough product features no flashback technology for white cast-free photos, AKA the selfie weapon you never knew you needed. Perfect for everyday use or while on the go, keep this portable stick in your pouch for pro level coverage and stunning selfies. Infused with argan oil and sunflower seed oil, it glides on seamlessly for even tone moisturized skin. This creamy buildable texture provides medium to full coverage with a soft satin finish, suitable for any and every selfie moment. Retails for $5.99, so that's really affordable. Let's just go ahead and put it on. So I'm gonna go in with classic beige and just apply that all over. So on one side of my face, I am gonna be applying it with a sponge. This is a Sephora sponge that comes in a multi-pack, and then I'm gonna be using the Jeffree Star brush. I know it's not clean. I cleaned it like 3 days ago. I don't got time to clean it, guys. So don't give me shit for it. I remember back when I used to have really bad acne, some of you guys would just like troll me so hard. Y'all would be like, well, that's why you got acne. You ain't washing your brushes. No, my acne was actually hormonal, so it had nothing to do with the bacteria on the brushes. My little rant. It wasn't all that. I was like maybe like one person, but you know how like that one negative comment is all it takes. This was back in the day though, like 4 years ago. I'm over it. No, I'm not. Okay, so taking classic beige, I'm gonna go ahead and just do a couple swipes. Oh, this might be my color though. I'm just taking a couple slides. So on the right side of my face, I am gonna take the sponge and I'm just gonna melt that into the skin. Hope it does. Okay, so that is the sponge side of my face. I have to say, it really did even my skin tone. Is it full coverage right off the bat? No, but I will say that it did cover up for the most part most of my things. There's obviously like a little blemish right on the side of my lip that it didn't necessarily cover up, but I'm not mad because overall the foundation looks really beautiful. It looks like skin, which I'm obsessed with. So moving on to the other side, again, I'm gonna take the same stick and I'm just gonna sweep it all over my face. And then I'm going to take my Jeffree Star JS1 brush, which is the foundation brush, and I'm just going to take that and just start to blend it out. Okay guys, overall, I really like the coverage of this foundation. The brush side definitely gave me more coverage as opposed to the beauty blender, or not the beauty blender side, but as opposed to the sponge side. I will say though, I like the finish of the sponge on this side more than I do the brush. I feel like the brush gave me more of like a soft matte effect, whereas the sponge really gave it luminosity. I'm gonna go in with the second layer on the sponge just because I feel like it's not even with the other layer. After that second layer, I have to say that the sponge definitely wins hands down as far as the finish of the foundation. It definitely gave me more of a soft satin finish. It still looks mattified, but it looks more radiant, and I really love that. I feel like it looks like skin, so it doesn't look like I'm wearing any makeup in person. Everything is just concealed. The matte side just looks a little drying for me. I don't know. It's just the way maybe the brush applied it. Okay guys, so the next thing they sent me was 4 bronzers, 4 loose highlights, and 2 of their most popular highlights. I'm gonna go ahead and take them out of the display and I'm gonna talk to you guys about them. Okay guys, so they did revamp their bronzers a little bit. They didn't exactly say how, it just says that it comes in 4 fabulous shades. It gives you beautiful beach babe bronze all year long. This is their number 1 bronzing shade in the shade Ticket to Brazil. It's featuring pearl pigments for a lit from within gleam. This new gel infused cream to powder hybrid formula will be sure to leave the skin looking luminous with natural sun-kissed glow. Retails for $4.99 on wetandwild.com. So now I'm just going to take the bronzer and the shade Ticket to Brazil. I'm going to take my Jeffree Star bronzing brush and I'm just going to go in it, tap off the excess, and I'm just going to start to bronze. So now moving in to the Wet n Wild loose highlighting powder. This is in the shade Hustle and Glow. It does come in 4 cruelty-free, gluten-free, fragrance-free, vegan shades. So this is infused with iridescent pigments. This shimmer powder illuminates the high points of the face for an intense radiant glow. Use it on its own or mix it with your favorite base product for an all-over glow. This will retail for $6.99 at CVS and on wetandwildbeauty.com. So the packaging is like loose setting powder. It does have the sticker on inside to kind of prevent the little holes from coming out. So typically what I would do is I would only cut half of this peel off sticker off, but I'm gonna take my Jeffree Star highlighting brush and I'm just gonna go into that. It looks a little too bronze. I picked the shade Hustle and Glow. Might be too deep for me, let's find out. Honestly, the way this made my skin glow, this is probably my favorite product. Oh my god, it looks so natural. It literally just blended in so beautifully. It just looks so beautiful. This is definitely one of those highlighters that I would want to put all over my body. I would use it for all over. If I was highlighting on a normal basis and I used this, I would use this as a base and then on top of it go in with a brighter highlighter, which I'm about to do. So next is the highlighting powders that they came out with. It comes with 2 new shades. The new shades is Bloom Time and Awesome Blossom. So Bloom Time and Awesome Blossom are the shades that I got. This is Bloom Time. It's more of a pinky iridescent color. It's infused with ultra reflective and microfine pearl pigments. This baked powder is everything you need to shine radiantly from inside out. This creamy formulation is infused with nylon for a silky smooth texture that allows for seamless blending. This will retail for $4.99 at CVS and your local Ulta's. So I'm just gonna take my Jeffree Star highlighting brush and I'm just gonna dip it in there, swirl it around a little bit, and I'm just gonna apply that to the top of my cheekbones. One, I'm just gonna go in and pop it right in the center of my cheekbone. Oh yes. That already looks amazing, just layering it on top of the other highlighting powder. I have to say I'm actually really amazed. I love how they blended in together. It just looks so beautiful. Like, I love the way it just blended into the skin. It looks so beautiful. I literally can't. Probably one of my favorite highlighters. You guys, I used to work for Becca Cosmetics, and this is probably a better formula. I am just saying. Okay, you guys. So the next thing that they did send me was a box full of their liquid cats. Suits. These are their lipsticks. I am actually a really big fan of the liquid lipsticks because I have been purchasing them for a while now. I won't say that I've been purchasing them in the most recent years, but back in the day when all I bought was drugstore, these were the liquid lipsticks that I was buying. Either these or Milani. They just had great formulations, super lightweight. And then they also sent me their new Liquid Catsuits Cream Liquid Eyeshadows. For the liquid eyeshadow, they do have cream, shimmers, and metallic. Slay your end game with this Mega Last Liquid Catsuit liquid eyeshadow that will guarantee your fierce cat-titude shines through. These high-impact liquid shadows feature a lightweight, silky formula while providing richly pigmented colors that stay put. This non-sticky, non-oily texture applies evenly and smoothly to open your lid to the liquid lust you've been craving. They retail for $4.99, so that's already amazing because I know that the Stila ones retail for like $20. So there is 13 shades. Again, they're cruelty-free, gluten-free, fragrance-free shades and 3 finishes. Okay, so first things first, I am going to go in with the Jeffree Star blending brush and I'm gonna go back into that bronzer and I'm just gonna apply it to my crease. This is gonna create a nice transition shade. Next, I'm just gonna take Shells and Whistles, which is a beautiful metallic shade, and I'm just gonna sweep that all over my eye. I just wanna see the color payoff in this. I'm not trying to do anything crazy just because I feel like that's gonna take up too much time in the video, but I am going to apply it. And I'm gonna take the Jeffree Star eyeshadow brush, and I'm just gonna blend out the edges if I can. That looks beautiful. I'm not going to sit here and say that it's as pigmented as the metallic shades from Stila, but those have glitter in them. These are just metallic shades, so they look beautiful. I'm gonna go ahead and finish the other eye off camera, and I'm gonna be right back. Next, you guys, I'm gonna take Fairy Tale Ending. This is more of a metallic, or a shimmer shade, I should say, and I'm just gonna take some on the back of my hand, and I am going to take my Jeffree Star brush, and I'm just gonna dip it into that, and I'm just gonna apply some to the inner corner of my eye. Next, I'm just gonna take the Megalast Liquid Catsuit High Shine Lipstick. This is in the shade Flirt Alert. I'm just gonna take that and apply it to my lips. Next, I'm gonna take Cedar Later. I'm just gonna take that and blend that out to the outer corners. I'm just gonna take my finger and I'm just gonna smudge that in. Okay, I kind of just created my own little custom wet lipstick just because I felt like the pink was too bright. So I mixed these two together and created my own custom lip. They just blended really nicely. I'm gonna go ahead and put some mascara and lashes off camera and I'll be right back. So guys, this is the final look. I went ahead and added some mascara. I did go in with the Better Than Sex mascara because that's just my favorite mascara. Overall, I really love this look. I think it's very natural. I think this is like everyday, beautiful, glowy skin and eyes. It's very rose gold toned. I have to say I'm obsessed with this glow. I'm obsessed with this foundation. It just looks so natural on the skin. I got no words other than it's amazing. I'm honestly obsessed. I have so many high-end foundations that don't give me how natural this looks. You know, you have a lot of foundations that give you the full coverage effect, but it doesn't look natural. It looks cakey or it just looks heavy. This looks like my skin, but better. I can't stop looking at myself in the mirror down here. I just look amazing. Without being said, I actually really like the eyeshadows. I think that they looked beautiful. Granted, I didn't do anything crazy. Like, I didn't do a cut crease. I didn't do anything crazy. I just did a simple monochromatic look. The highlighter, I'm obsessed with that loose highlighter. I'm obsessed with the normal highlighter too, but the loose highlighter just looks so natural. It really diffused the overall look of the skin and the glow. I'm obsessed, guys. Overall, this whole collection is a 10 out of 10 for me. I have no products in this collection that I was like, oh, I don't know about that. I do wish that they had sent me a setting powder though, because I feel like I definitely should have powdered my under eye, but I was too late in the game for me to just go back. It would have taken away from all this beauty. So with that being said, guys, that basically concludes today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you want to see more videos from me, make sure you hit that subscribe button if you haven't done so already. Turn on those notifications so you can be notified every time I make a video. And if you watch this video out of the very end, leave a peach emoji down below in the comments so that everyone's like, WTF, what is happening? And make sure you give this video a thumbs up. And until next time, guys, you guys hands out.